Friends, when we think about grammar, we think about marks. Our outlook towards grammar is very different. First of all, we should keep it in mind that we study grammar to improve our communication skills. To score marks in academics or in competitive exam is secondary object. So friends, today we will study change the voice. This is a very important topic. And while studying this topic, we should keep in mind that we are studying this topic first of all to improve our communication skills. Then secondly, we should think about scoring marks. Yes, in competitive exams, in academics also, it is very important. Now let us start to think about voice. What is voice? Voice is that form of verb which tells us whether the action is done by subject or the action is done on object. There are two types of voice, active voice and passive voice. What is active voice? Active voice is that form of verb which tells us that the action is done by subject. Means, subject is more important than action. What is passive voice? Passive voice is that form of verb which tells us that action is done on object. What does it mean? It means that action is more important than subject. How to identify a particular sentence is in passive voice? So there are some keywords. Those keywords will tell us that the particular sentence is in passive voice. Which are those keywords? Those keywords are am, is, are, was, where, be, been, being. So these are the keywords which always come with third form of the verb, that is V3. We will call V3 to the third form of the verb. If such type of construction is there, that is am, is, are, was, where, be, been, being plus V3, we should think that it is passive voice. So is there any other important rule in passive voice or important characteristic? Yes. When we convert active voice into passive voice, the subject of the active voice becomes object of the passive voice. Secondly, the object of the active voice becomes subject of the passive voice. This is the important thing. Is there any pattern by which we can change active voice into passive voice? Yes. We will change it according to the tenses and according to the types of sentence. First we will take simple present tense. In simple present tense we will convert assertive sentence and interrogative sentence into passive voice. As far as imperative sentence is concerned, we will take it specially at the end of the topic. Before going to all the tenses, I must tell you that there are four tenses which will not be changed into passive voice. Tense number 1, future continuous tense. Tense number 2, present perfect continuous tense. Past perfect continuous tense and future perfect continuous tense. All perfect continuous tense and future continuous tense will not change in passive voice. Forcefully we can change them, but such type of constructions are not used in general communication. So we should avoid it. And it is not asked and it is not useful, it is meaningless. Let us begin with the simple present tense. In simple present tense, we will first take assertive sentence. In assertive sentence, we are taking very easy example. He writes a letter. In this sentence, he is subject, writes is first form of the verb, and a letter is object. So object will become subject. So beginning of the passive voice will be a letter. Now, I have already told you, or I must tell you that when should we use amizar, when should we use was, where, and when should we use be, being, been? Whenever there is first form of the verb in active voice, we should use am, is, or are. If there is V2, second form of the verb in active voice, we should use was or where. If there is modal auxiliary in active voice, modal auxiliary, shall, will, may, might, can, could, should, would. These are the examples of modal auxiliary. If these modal auxiliaries are there, we should use be plus V3. When should we use being? whenever there is ing form in the sentence, means all continuous forms of the verbs, instead of removing ing completely, we will make it being. We will give a special attention to ing and we will convert it into being, and we will use it before third form of the verb. Lastly, been. All the sentences which have, has, had plus V3. All the sentences in which there is construction of have, has, had plus V3. In such a sentences, we will use been in the middle of have, has, or had and V3. Alright. Now let us begin once again. Our sentence in simple present tense. Assertive sentence, positive. In assertive sentence, we are taking first positive sentence. Our example was, he writes a letter. The verb is writes. V1. We will use am, is, are. What is the answer? A letter is written by him. He becomes him. Now I would like to tell you about this also. How many personal pronouns are important? I, we, he, she, and they. The object form of I is me and subject form of me is I. Object form of we is us and subject form of us is we. Object form of he is him and subject form of him is he. Object form of her, she is her and subject form of her is she. Object form of they is them and subject form of them is they. In this way we will make a change. Here also we have made one change, that is he writes a letter. A letter is written by him. The object form of he is him. That is what we have used. Subject became object, right? Now second important example. Here we will take negative example. I do not beat my sister. I do not beat my sister. Object is my sister. It will become subject in passive voice. My sister is not beaten by me. This example is different. Because in this example we have got do. Whenever do or does is there in the sentence, we should use am or is or are. So here we have used is. I do not beat my sister. My sister is not beaten by me. Now we will take another example. Now here we will take interrogative sentence. In interrogative sentence, we have two types of interrogative sentence. SO type question and WH type of question. First we will take SO type question. Does he want this book? What is the question? Does he want this book? Here also we will use M is R. What is the answer? Is this book wanted by him? What is the answer? Is this book wanted by him? This book was object, here it became subject. He became him. It became object. Right? Next question. Which book do you refer? This is WH question. Which book do you refer? What will be the answer? Which book is referred by you? What is the answer? Which book is referred by you? In this way, we can make changes in simple present tense. Now we will change simple past tense. Here we have to make only one change. All V1 will become V2 in this sentence. He writes a letter will become he wrote a letter. Wrote, second form of the verb. Therefore, we will use was and were. Was or were. He wrote a letter. What is answer? A letter was written by him. A letter was written by him. Second important question. First we had taken, I do not beat my sister. In simple past tense we will make, I did not beat my sister. Did is there. Whenever in the sentence the word did will come, we will use was or were. I did not beat my sister. What is the answer? My sister was not beaten by me. I use was. My sister was not beaten by me. Next example. Did he want this book? External question. Did he want this book? Answer is, was this book wanted by him? What is the answer? Was this book wanted by him? Next question is WH question. First our example was, which book do you refer? Now, our example will be, which book did you refer? Answer is, what is the question? Which book did you refer? Answer is, which book was referred by you? Facebook was referred by you is the answer. We have used was because in sentence did is there, right? Now simple future tense. Next tense is simple future tense. First example, it was he writes a letter. In future tense it will be he will write a letter. Now will is there, so modal auxiliary is there. So we will use be to convert active voice into passive voice, and without be we cannot write third form of the verb. He will write a letter. A letter will be written by him. What is the answer? A letter will be written by him. Second question, I do not meet my sister. In present tense it was I do not meet my sister. In future tense it will be simple future, it will be I will not meet my sister. What is the question? I will not beat my sister. What is the answer? My sister will not be beaten by me. My sister will not be beaten by me. Third sentence. It was does he want this book? Now in simple future. Will he want this book? Will he want this book? What is the answer? Will this book be wanted by him? Will this book be wanted by him? Next important question. WH question. Which book do you refer? In simple present tense it was which book do you refer? Here in simple future tense it will be which book will you refer? Which book will you refer? Answer. Which book will be referred by you? Which book will be referred by you? This is the answer. Now here we have finished all the simple tenses. That is simple present, simple past and simple future. Now we will go to continuous form. First we will take present continuous form. In present continuous form, our first sentence is in present tense, simple present tense, our sentence was he writes a letter. Now here we will take he is writing a letter. What is the special? What is the speciality of this sentence? ING form. I have already told you. Whenever ING form is there, we will make it being. He is writing a letter. What is the answer? A letter is being written by him. MSR will remain as it is. Only one change. ING will become being. He is writing a letter. A letter is being written by him. Second example question. Second important question. I am not beating my sister. I am not beating my sister. Negative question we will take first. I am not beating my sister. My sister is not being beaten by me. What is the question? My sister is not being beaten by me. Now next question that we have to take question. Is he writing a letter? What is the question? Is he writing a letter? Now our answer is a letter being written by him? What is the answer? Is a letter being written by him? Now the last question. Last question is WH question. What was our first question? Which book do you refer? Now here we will take which book are you referring? What is the question? Which book are you referring? Now what will be the answer? Which book is being referred by you? Which book is being referred by you? This is present continuous tense. Now we will take past continuous tense. Our past continuous, first example, very simple now. MSR will become was were. That is the only thing. For example, he was writing, he is writing a letter. Now here we will take he was writing a letter. And answer will be a letter was being written by him. He was writing a letter. A letter was being written by him. Second question. I was beating my sister. I was beating my sister. What will be the answer? My sister was being beaten by me. My sister was being beaten by me. See, I don't have sister, but still I have taken this example. Maybe those who have sisters, they may feel it bad. But this is only example, so don't take it serious. Now last question. Which book is he? Our subject was you. Which book are you referring? Which book are you referring? But in past tense, what it will be? Which book were you referring? Which book were you referring? What will be the answer? Which book was being referred by you? Now your subject is book. Therefore, instead of where, we have used was. Which book was being referred by you? Now last tense, future continuous tense. I have already told you that we cannot make changes in this sentence. we cannot convert future continuous tense into passive voice, right? Why? Forcefully we can make it, but it is not useful. It is meaningless sentence. Now the next important tense, that is present perfect tense. In present perfect tense, we have to follow the same pattern. That is assertive sentence, positive sentence, negative sentence, S-no type question and WH type of question. Now the first sentence was he writes the letter. In present perfect tense, it will be he has written a letter. He has written a letter. Here we will use been, very important word. We have already used am is are. We have already used was where. We have already used be. We have already used being. Now the last word that we are using been. He has written a letter. What will be the answer? A letter has been written by him. Yes, has and written. In the middle of both of these words, we will use been. He has written a letter. A letter has been written by him. Second question. It was I do not beat my sister. Here we will write I have not beaten my sister. I have not beaten my sister. My sister has not beaten by me. Now why has I along with I we use have. But if the subject is third person singular, we use has. So my sister is third person singular. Therefore we have used has. What was the question? I have not beaten my sister. My sister has not been beaten by me. Alright, next example. It was does he want this book? Has he wanted this book? What will be the question now? Has he wanted this book? What will be the answer? Has this book been wanted by him? Has this book been wanted by him? Now WH question. It was which book do you refer it was? Now in perfect tense. Which book has you preferred? Which book has you preferred? In passive voice, which book has been preferred by you? Which book has been preferred by you? Now, past perfect tense. This is the last tense that we have to take. First question. In present perfect tense, it was have and has. But in past perfect tense, we will use only had. Our question in present, simple present tense was, he writes a letter. Here we will say, he had written a letter. What is the question? He had written a letter. What is the answer? A letter had been written by him. A letter had been written by him. Second question, I do not beat my sister. What will be the sentence in past perfect? I had not beaten my sister. I had not beaten my sister. What will be the answer? My sister had not been beaten by me. My sister had not been beaten by me. Next question. Does he want this book? What will be this sentence in past perfect? Had he wanted this book? Had he wanted this book? What will be the answer? Had this book been wanted by him? Had this book been wanted by him? Now last question. Which book do you refer? In past perfect, it will be which book had you referred? Which book had you referred? What will be the answer? Which book had been referred by you? Is the answer. Which book had been referred by you? Alright. Now the last question, that is future perfect tense. The same construction we will use that we have used in present perfect tense. Just we will add shall or will. The first answer. First question. Our example was he writes a letter. Now in future perfect tense, he will have written a letter. He will have written a letter. A letter will have been written by him. Is the answer. A letter will have been written by him. Second one. Our first question was I do not beat my sister. Now what will we write here? I will have not beaten my sister. Or, I shall not have beaten my sister. What will be the answer? My sister will not have been beaten by me. My sister will not have been beaten by me. Next question. Does he want this book? How it will be in future perfect tense? Does he want this book? Will he have wanted this book? Will he have wanted this book? What is the answer? Will this book have been wanted by him? Will this book have been wanted by him, or will this book have been wanted by him? No problem. Next question: which book do you refer? What was the last question? Which book do you refer? In future perfect tense, it will be: which book will have he referred? Which book will have he referred? What will be the answer? Which book will have been referred by him? Which book will have been referred by him? So in this way, we have completed all the tense. Just one important sentence is left, that is imperative sentence. We will take few examples. What is the speciality of imperative sentence? Main characteristic. It does not have subject, and therefore we have to make some other arrangement. Suppose the sentence is switch off the light. Switch off the light. In this sentence, we will use let plus be. How will be the answer? Let the light be switched off. Let the light be switched off. In other words, if it is request, we can say you are ordered to switch off the light. You are ordered to switch off the light. If you have to make a sentence of request, you will say you are requested to switch off the light. Another example: close the door. Let the door be closed. You are ordered to close the door. You are requested to close the door. Any of the sentences is correct. All types are correct. There is no problem at all. We can make all types of sentences. This is how we can make this sentence. One important example. Many people ask to each other to tease each one. What is that? Change the voice. If the example is change the voice, how you will change this word, this sentence into passive voice? Change the voice. Let the voice be changed. What is the answer? Let the voice be changed. Right? All right. We have taken everything about this, but one important tip that I would like to give you at the end of the topic. Indirect into indirect speech, when we convert question, direct question into indirect speech, we make it statement. But in change the voice, question should remain as question. Question should remain as question. We should not convert question into statement. This is the very important thing that you have to remember. Remember, we make statement. Question is made statement in direct into indirect speech, not in change the voice. In change the voice, question remains question. Even in question, we have question mark at the end. At the same time, in answer also, we have question mark at the end. Alright. You have given long time for me. Thank you for watching this video. I'm really very thankful. Thank you.